appreciation towards the organization, because today is about posture smiling. Posture smiling, the techniques to reveal what's inside the black box. And this day is organized inside a building that's called the black box. So let's see what's happening in the black box. I want to start with telling you about a topic that was the main topic that kept me busy during more than 6 months last year. Posture smiling methodology. During my graduation at this university, Eindhoven University of Technology, I developed a posture smiling methodology. I want to start this presentation in the first part with talking about the methodology. Why did I develop this methodology? How it was developed? And giving an overview of a project life cycle according to this methodology. And in the second part of this presentation, I will talk about the posture smiling project that I executed at Rabobank using this methodology. There are several reasons for having a posture smiling methodology. The first reason is that the methodology can give comfort to people with little or no posture smiling background. It explains the activities that are required in a posture smiling project. Just like almost every project, a posture smiling project requires good planning and management. You can't just put your head in the ground and see what's going to happen. Methodology can support you in for good planning and management. And the third reason is that executing a project using a structured framework allows for the replication of your project. You can, for example, execute your project again in future, or execute similar process mining projects. And last but not least, a process mining methodology can share the best practices from the process mining community and prevent from pitfalls. It can help us to prevent from reinventing the wheel. The process mining methodology that I developed contains several ingredients. The first ingredient was process mining literature. For example, literature about event logs and retrieving the information from the event logs and interpreting this information was quite interesting in this context. But also literature from other domains. As Anne already told, data mining is a partly overlapping domain with process mining, and for example the methodologies in the data mining field could be interesting to give some ideas about our process mining methodology. And the third main ingredient was you, people from the process mining community, people that have process mining experience. During the development of this methodology, I read a lot of project summaries and experience, and I discussed with a lot of experts about this methodology. This figure shows an overview of a life cycle of a posture smiling methodology according to this methodology. It starts with the scoping phase, getting some basic process understanding and formulating the objectives of your project. Next phase is data understanding, locating the data that is required for this for answering the business questions, exploring this data and verifying this data if it's reliable. In the event log creation phase, the data is selected, extracted and prepared so that it's suitable as input for process mining tools. And in the process mining phase, you're gonna use process mining techniques to analyze this event log. First, to get a bit of more knowledge and feeling with the process that's contained in the event log. And then after, you're gonna use the process mining techniques to answer the business questions that you formulated in the scoping phase. Those results have to be evaluated, first validating them, verifying them, but also check with your principal if the results are answering the business questions. And at the end, you can present your results and give ideas how the process can be improved using these results. I executed a process mining project at Rabobank for the invoice process. And I started by asking the manager of the process about this process, to get some basic understanding of the process, to get some, for example, some high level characteristics of the process. But I also asked him to draw his process. And this was the process as he explained it to me. It starts with a company that is sending an invoice for a product or services they delivered. This can be done in several ways. First way is using an e-invoicing system. Second way is sending an email and the invoice as PDF attachment. And the third way is the traditional way, use it just by mail. All these types of invoices are loaded into the SAP environment of the Rabobank. There takes several activities place. It starts with registering an invoice, thereafter the invoice is checked. When it's a product, the goods need to be checked, seeing if the product is delivered. And then the manager can approve the invoice so that the invoice can be paid. This part of the process is executed in the SAP system and is locked, and we focused for this project on this part of the process. Together with the principal, I formulated several objectives for this project. And we derived specific questions to trigger the analysis phase and to see what data we needed. The first objective was getting more insight, seeing the process behind the KPIs, seeing how KPIs were composed and how to influence the KPIs. Second objective was cutting costs. An invoice costs about 9 euros for handling an invoice, and the principal wanted to decrease this amount to about 7.5 euros an invoice. So he asked me to check where we could decrease the amount of effort spent on an invoice. Third goal that we formulated was about increasing the quality of the work. Not all invoices were handled STP, straight through processing. For most invoices, there were extra activities needed, or for example, rework. And you wanted to know where the rework and extra activities were executed and why, what the cause of this rework was. And the last main objective was risk management. This process is about paying money to somebody, and you want to control this process. Therefore, the Rabobank implemented segregation of duties. For all the main activities, everyone had a role, and no one was allowed to execute more of the main activities. And the principal wanted to know if there were people that had too many rights. Using the event log and process mining tool, this was the main process that I discovered. It's quite similar as described by the manager. It both starts with registering an invoice, then checking the details of the invoice, eventually checking goods, and thereafter the invoice can be approved. In case of the event log, there was an extra activity which was automatically executed. It was sending the invoice to the payment system. But this process model fits only for 60% of the invoices. Increasing this percentage, we get, for example, this process model. Now there are extra activities. For example, an activity to register a company that has not sent an invoice before to the Rabobank. And if you want to see the process model of all invoices, this is the process model. And now the main structure, the main flow of the invoices, as described by the manager, is not recognizable anymore. To accomplish on-time payment, Rabobank has several deadlines. Each role has a deadline for executing his activities. For example, checking an invoice should be done within 2 days, and confirming an invoice should be done within 8 days. They have a quite good score, and if you summarize all those days, you have a total of 18 days. So looking to this figures, you would expect that most invoices are paid within 18 days. That's not the case. About 85% of all invoices is paid within 30 days. So it was interesting to discover the cause. And I saw that there were invoices like this one. This is an example of an invoice. This invoice starts by registering it, then is sent to then is checked, and then is sent back to the registration department. And there are a lot more activities, and never this deadline is crossed, but the total amount of days is more than 30. And this can also be done in the same department. The people are sending an invoice to each other, never crossing a deadline, so you won't see that this on the KPIs. This is not what you want, because each time the deadline is starting all over again. I showed this process model to the manager and I asked him which activities were part of the happy flow and which activities are not part of the happy flow. Looking to the activities that are not part of the happy flow, I investigated why they were triggered. For example, the activity on the left on the top, that activity was a big coffee company that was sending a lot of invoices to the Rabobank, and each time after 2 weeks, when the invoice was not paid yet, they were sending a reminder to the Rabobank that they haven't received the payment. And Rabobank was sending them a letter back that they have not paid the invoice yet, because the policy was to pay invoices after 30 days. So this was waste. It cost a lot of effort and was not adding value. Another example, for quite about 5% of the registered invoices is sent back to the registration department because the registration has to be adapted. Every employee that's in the green part of this figure has an average that is lower than 5%. And every employee that's in the white part has an average that is higher than this 5%. And if you look at this employee is registering less than 4% of all invoices, but more than 20% of all invoices that need to be adapted are registered by this employee. So that was quite remarkable, because those employees are doing exactly the same work. And yeah, you probably can improve this, for example, to give training to this employee. The last example that I want to show you is about risk management. Using the event log and the process mining tool, I could assign all employees to the main activities. And employees were not allowed to execute more of those activities. But there were employees that had authorization to execute more of those activities. That was against the rules of the Rabobank. So Rabobank was bearing risk because of this. Last 20 minutes I talked about a process mining project and executing a process mining project. And a project, like what's in its definition, is ending. And you also have to think about the next steps after your process mining project. For example, look to the BPM lifecycle and see what BPM related activities can support the further improvement of the process. Or in the context of process mining, also think about using process mining techniques to monitor or support your process. This was my presentation. Thank you for your attention.
We have time for some questions. For time.
Every day. It's very interesting. Did you also use a time frame for when the summer people are leaving for, and then the time of handling will be longer, I suppose?
Yeah, that was quite interesting. You saw some differences for in the summer. In the summer, a lot of people were on holiday and they were hiring people for example, the registration of invoices that were just for some students that had not had much training. And so, that, for example, it took quite some more time to execute specific activities. So, yeah, there were differences that we saw.
And did you reach 7.5 euro?
I don't know what the cost, handling cost of an invoice are at the moment, but I think Process Mining helped them to show some improvements for this process, so I think it's lower than it was before. Are there any other questions?
How much time would it, I mean, for you it was more experimenting or linked to your study, but how much time would it normally take? So can you make a combination of how big and how much, so the analyze file, the phase, or so I'm trying to find a sort of how could you sell this, we can do this in 1 month or can you do it in 3 months?
I think so. I'll try. You first have to start with formulating some objectives, and that won't take very long. But then you have to locate and extract data that you want to use, and that can be very problematic. So don't taking that time into account and just focusing on having that data and analyzing it and discussing with the organization. I think if you have some process knowledge or involvement of people from the company that know that process, it can be done within a month.
In the type of organization, how difficult was it to get to those log files? I mean, I know this kind of institutions and they are very careful in finding the right person who can actually know the file, find the file, and then being allowed to give it to you.
Yeah, that was quite difficult. I didn't work with SAP before, and I didn't know anything about it. So first they were telling me, we don't lock that kind of information. And then I looked on the internet and I searched for information and talked to other people. And then at a later moment, a few weeks later, I saw that probably this data was locked. And I talked to other people that could help me a bit further, but they were not able to extract data from the system. So at the end, I talked to an architect of SAP, and he helped me, and we built something in the business warehouse. Much of this data was daily copied to a data warehouse, and in the data warehouse, we were able finally to extract this data. But that was about 3 months later.
Okay, thank you.
We have time for one more question.
I'm just wondering at which level of the organization you collaborated with Rabobank, so whether that was at a senior level or an operational level or a specialist group?
Yeah, the principal of this project was the manager of the invoice process, so the manager, he knew the whole process, but more important, he was the owner of the data of the process. So. When we needed to have the rights to use this data, and he could give me those rights, that was most important. And sometimes we have to talk to people, managers of this manager, for example, because we wanted to have time from specific people to spend some days to get the data. But most of the time, the manager of this process was the one who could support me with the most things.
Thank you. Okay, I suggest that further questions we can you can find time in the break and ask him more things. Thanks a lot. It's a very good example. Thanks a lot for sharing.